Now we're going to see glaucoma. Glaucoma is open angle glaucoma or closed angle glaucoma, open or secondary. And closed angle glaucoma could be acute or chronic. Closed angle glaucoma could be acute or chronic. The pathogenesis in open angle glaucoma is that there is decrease in the absorption or drainage of the aqueous humor if it is primary. In secondary, would be due to obstruction of the drainage, for example, if there is hypopyon in uveitis, for example, the white blood cell are blocking the drainage, or in hemorrhage, red blood cell will decrease the drainage, or in retinal detachment, the retinal element will decrease the drainage. For closed angle glaucoma, the mechanism is that there is increase in the intraocular pressure because there is dislocation of the lenses or permanent dilation of the pupil that promotes that the aqueous humor that is on the anterior chamber goes to the posterior chamber, and due to the increase in intraocular pressure pushes the iris against the cornea, so the angle between the iris and the cornea is closed. So for that is closed angle glaucoma. If it is a acute presentation, the patient presents with painful red eye, and the pupil will be fixed. This is the difference between uveitis, in which the pupils are constricted and poor reactive to light. Here the pupil will be not reactive, fixed. In chronic causes, we have the same mechanism of action. The same mechanism of action, I mean that the angle is closed, but here it is due to a vascular disease. There is increase in angiogenesis due to diabetes mellitus or retinal vein occlusion, and the angiogenesis in the iris produces closing of the angle. In acute, this is an emergency. We need immediately referral to the ophthalmologist. The patient presents with nausea, vomiting. We would see a hazy cornea. The patient can complain of very painful eye, and suddenly, let's say that the patient was in the movies, and suddenly when the lights turned off, now the patient is presenting with this. So we need to decrease the intraocular pressure. We would do this by giving intravenous mannitol or acetazolamide, or well, acetazolamide could be intravenous or oral, and we can give pilocarpine to increase the flow through the intraocular mesh bore and Schlemm canal, or timolol to decrease the production of aqueous humor. Sometimes we can do laser peripheral iridotomy. This will promote or produce a hole on the iris that will increase the angle between the iris and the cornea. This could also be done prophylactically in order that the patient never develops this acute emergency condition. And this usually presents in older patients like 55 to 70 years old. For open angle glaucoma, the treatment would be, we can diminish the synthesis giving beta blockers like timolol, betaxolol, castolol, giving alpha agonist, alpha 1, norepinephrine will produce vasoconstriction, decreasing aqueous humor synthesis. We can give acetazolamide, dorzolamide, brinzolamide, that are the carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. We will block the carbonic anhydrase, that is the one that produces the aqueous humor. We could also give alpha-2 adrenergic receptor agonist. This would be a pracronidine and brimatine. This would promote, this would decrease the synthesis of vagus humor. And we can increase the trabecular meshwork or uvoscleral tract drainage. The uvoscleral tract would be increased if we give prostaglandin analogs, prostaglandin F2 alpha, like latanoprost, bimatoprost, troprost. And of adverse effect, we would see pigmentation of the iris and growth of the eyelashes. And for the trabecular meshwork, we could give cholinergic medications. Direct would be pilocarpine, acetylcholine, or carbacol. And indirect one would inhibit the acetylcholine esterase enzyme, like reversibly, physostigmine, and irreversibly would be etiofolate. Etiofolate puts a phosphate in the acetylcholine esterase enzyme, thereby inhibiting irreversibly. We could also do trabeculoplasty for both cases if don't respond to medical treatment. And the diagnosis is made for open angle glaucoma with tonometry. This is the most accurate test. And for closed angle glaucoma with goinoscopy. This is the gold standard. The goinoscopy will allow us to measure the angle between the iris and the cornea in slit lamp examination. And the tonometry will measure the indentation that we generate when we put pressure. We will put measurable pressure at the cornea. We will find that there is increase in the intraocular pressure. Additionally, in the fundoscopic examination, we can find that the ratio of the cup to the disc is more than 0.5. The normal is less than 0.3. But for closed angle glaucoma, even though the gold standard in diagnosis is goinoscopy, sometimes we cannot do this immediately in the emergency department. We would ask for ophthalmologic referral, but we cannot do this immediately. So best initial test would be to do tonometry.